pork shellings. When I lose my smile, when my thoughts get jumbled, when the air and BS get too thick, can't take a breath without getting sick.
Just a reminder, Ohio Quarter Horse Youth are selling 50-50 raffle tickets. Six for $5, 15 for 10. Look for them in the bright orange shirts. Last year's winner won over $1,700. As soon as we get all of our crowd into their seats, we will be getting underway with the DAC Freestyle. Did you know that DAC Vitamins and Minerals are celebrating their 35th anniversary this year? We want to thank each and every DAC customer for your loyal patronage. We appreciate you and are proud that you put your faith in us for years. Thanks to you and our affiliation with the National Animal Supplement Council, partnering with leaders in feed technology, performance, horse nutrition, and Alltech, we have been able to stay on top as one of the leading supplement companies in the country. Stop by and visit DAC at their booth in Congress Hall. DAC Vitamins and Minerals offer a natural hair care line. Stop in the DAC booth and pick up a bottle of the hottest fly repellent on the market, DAC Citronella Spray. Stop in the booth for more details on this all-natural and safe application to repel flies and insects. Once again, everybody come on in and have a seat. We're just about ready to begin.
like Ronnie Van Zant said, turn it up.
Big wheels keep on turning. Carry me home to see my kin. Singing songs about the Southland. I miss Alabama once again, and I think it's a sin. What I heard Mr. Young say about her, what I heard O'Neill put her down, well, I hope Neil Young will remember. Southern men don't need him around anyhow.
Did you know that DAC Vitamins and Minerals have more than 40 proven equine supplements? From your daily multivitamin to joint digestion, reproduction, and fertility specialty products. DAC also carries a complete line of livestock products called DAC Show Contender for show pig, steer, goat, and sheep. If everyone would kindly take a seat, if you haven't already, we're going to start in 5 minutes.
Something about a truck in a farmer's field, a no trespass sign, and time to kill. Nobody's gonna get hurt, so what's the big deal? Something about a truck in a farmer's field, and somebody there sitting on ice after a long hard day makes it taste just right on that drop tailgate on a summer night. There's somebody there sitting on ice, and somebody girl in a red sundress with an ice cold beer pressed against her lips. In that farmer's field will make a boy miss. There's something about a girl in a red sundress. And there's something about a kiss that's gonna lead to more on that drop tailgate back behind the corn. The most natural thing you ever felt before. There's somebody kiss that's gonna lead to more. And there's somebody truck in a field, and a girl in a red sundress with an ice cold beer to her lips, begging for another kiss. And there's somebody you and me and the birds and the bees, and Lord have mercy, it's a beautiful thing. Ain't nothing about it, look. There's somebody truck. Somebody creep around 2 a.m. After a few of those beers, you wanna dive on in. You don't need no clothes to just hang them on a limb. There's somebody creep around 2 a.m. And there's somebody truck in a field, and a girl in a red sundress with an ice cold beer to her lips.
Bye. that's what we do, but there's more to us than that. If you want to know who we are, it's on the logos of our caps. We're mountaineers, we're volunteers, we're the tide that rolls, we're Seminoles.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the All-American Quarter Horse Congress Freestyle, brought to you by DAC. We're glad you're here. Now, the first item of business, as you know, this is the only freestyle in the country where the audience is one of the scores. Now, to make sure that our applause meter is working properly, we're going to run a test. And I want you all to imagine you have just seen the greatest run you've ever seen. And of course, as you'll remember, after each one, I'll be asking you to score it with your applause. So here we go. On the count of three, one, two, three, score that one. Well, that almost worked. Okay, so we're going to be extra happy this time and extra excited, so let her go. Perfect. Thank you all very much. And welcome this evening to NRHA Open Freestyle. Open and non-pro reining, presented by DAC. In just a moment, we will present the national anthem. But before we do that, I want to recognize NRHA judges, Holly Hover, Jennifer Thompson, and Judge Larry Little, monitoring the applause meter. So we welcome you. That's judges' appreciation, depending on how you did, right? So at this point in time, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our national anthem. If you would, stand, and we present the national anthem. Well, once again, good evening, and if the rehearsal this morning was any indicator at all, this will be another good show here in Columbus, Ohio. And we are ready to begin. Draw number one is number 5540, Lindsay Handren with Roxy's Custom Crown, Ferndale, Michigan. Scribe Scratch, draw number three, Scratch, draw number three.
Come and move that in my direction. So thankful for that, it's such a blessing, yeah. Turn every situation into heaven, yeah. Oh, you are my
sunrise on the darkest day. Got me feeling some kind of way. Make me wanna savor every moment slowly, slowly. You fit me, telling me love how you put it on. Got the only key, know how to turn it on. The way you nibble on my ear, the only words I wanna hear. Baby, take it slow so we can last long.
Tú eres el imán y yo soy el metal. Me voy acercando y voy armando el plan. Solo con pensarlo se acelera el pulso.
Oh yeah. Ya, ya me está gustando más de lo normal. Todo mi sentido va pidiendo más. Estoy que tomarlo sin ningún apuro.
Despacito. Voy a respirar tu cuello despacito. Deja que te diga cosas al oído. Para que te acuerdes si no estás conmigo. Despacito. Quiero desnudarte a besos despacito. Como las paredes de tu laberinto. Y hacer de tu cuerpo todo un manuscrito. Pasito a pasito, suave, suavecito, nos vamos pegando poquito a poquito. Y es que esa belleza es un rompecabezas, pero para montarlo aquí tengo la pieza, oye. Oh yeah. Despacito, quiero respirar tu cuello despacito. Deja que le diga cosas al oído, para que te acuerdes si no estás conmigo. Despacito, quiero desnudarte a besos despacito. Como en las paredes de tu laberinto. Cerré tu cuerpo todo un manuscrito.
This is how we do it down in Puerto Rico. I just wanna hear you screaming, ay bendito. I can go forever cuando esté contigo.
Pasito a pasito, suave suavecito, nos vamos pegando poquito a poquito.
Enseñas a mi boca los lugares favoritos.
Pasito a pasito, suave suavecito, nos vamos pegando poquito a poquito.
That was Lindsay Hendren. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to do that score with your applause. How about it? Score 203 on that ride. 203 for Lindsay Hendren.
That'd be nice.
Ready now for draw number two, number 5270, Martin Schwartz. with Show Me Sterling, owned by Guy Cutshaw, Milton, Kentucky. Show Me Sterling is his registered name, but to most, he's just Sterling. The 9-year-old Appaloosa Quarter Mix is the one and only horse of owner Guy Cutshaw of Milton, Kentucky. Martin is the horse trainer from LaGrange. They've been a team for 5 years, and they hope to entertain you tonight as they make their debut at Freestyle Reining. Martin Schwartz. It's sport time. That was Martin Schwartz, ladies and gentlemen, on Show Me Sterling from Milton, Kentucky. Next up will be drawn number 4, Leah Moore with Kayla Shonlin on deck, Carla Ribordi in the hole. Score 208 on the last ride, 208 for Martin Schwartz. Draw number 3 is the scratch. Coming in now, draw number 4, number 1757, Leah Michelle Moore was spooked by Starlight from Farmersville, Ohio. Kayla Shelnut will be on deck. Leah Michelle Moore, and now it's score time. That's Leah Michelle Moore on Spooked by Starlight from Farmersville, Ohio. Next up is draw number five, Kayla Shelnut. And a score of 212 and a half on that drive, 212 and one half. Ready now for draw number five, number 4383. Kayla Shelnut with Tag This from Loganville, Georgia. Make some noise if you've ever driven down that Atlanta highway. If you have, you probably heard of the shack that's on the side of the road. Well, Kayla and Taxi are taking you on a trip down to the Love Shack. Okay, LaShelle Knott, ladies and gentlemen. And that's Kayla Shelnut, ladies and gentlemen, and it's score time. Kayla Shelnut on tag this from Loganville, Georgia. We're up to draw number six now. Carla Ribordi with Bob Pierce on deck. Jacob Cam in the hole. Score 209 and a half on the last ride, 209 and one half. Next up, draw number six, number 5573, Carla Ribordi with A Spark of Sunshine, owned by Petra Pearson, Cox Creek, Kentucky.
Yeah.
Carla Ribordi. And now one more time for the score. The new score to beat, 2:23.5 for Carla Ribordi. Coming in next, draw number 7, number 6805, Rob Pierce with RCY King Silver from Bishop, California. Jacob Cam's on deck, BB Shortle in the hole.
Softly
Rob Pierce, ladies and gentlemen, and now it's score time. Score 219 on that ride, 219 for Rob Pierce from Bishop, California. Next work, draw number 8, number 6657, Jacob Cam with Okie's Poker Chloe, owned by Whitney Lee Locke, Lima, Ohio. BB Shortle's on deck. Dan James in the hole. They dedicate their performance tonight to our nation's first responders for their bravery in the line of duty. We support, celebrate, honor, and most importantly, say thank you for their service, sacrifice, and commitment. Ladies and gentlemen, Jacob Cam.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's score time for Jacob Cam. How about it? And a score of 213 and one half on that ride, 213 and a half. Coming in next, draw number 9, number 4856, B.B. Shortall with Happy Trail from Baird, Nebraska. This will be B.B.'s and Happy's last ride together. Join in a party celebration of Happy's and B.B.'s friendship. Mi vida loca.
If you're coming with me, you need nerves of steel. 'Cause I take corners on two wheels. But it's a never-ending circus ride. Pain of heart need not apply.
Oh,
B.B. Shortle, ladies and gentlemen. Now it's score time. B.B. Shortle, Baird, Nebraska. Score 213 on that ride, 213 for B.B. Shortle. Next up is draw number 10, number 4944, Dan James on Don Magnum. Dan James of Double Dan Horsemanship is here riding Don Magnum. Together, they just finished competing on the Australian reigning team at the World Equestrian Games. Dan is based in Midway, Kentucky with wife Elizabeth and daughter Isabella. Coming in now, draw number 10.
I call that bold talk for a one-eyed fat man.
Fill your hand, you son of a bitch.
Thank you.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's score time. The new score to beat with a 232 for Dan James. That was draw number 10, ladies and gentlemen. It's halftime, and now in just a few minutes, you'll be treated to the presentation of the All-American Quarter Horse Congress Queen.
See the color in your eyes. I'm telling myself I'm gonna be all right.
Oh, and by the way, the 50-50 winner receives $2,475. Crazy money. $2,475. Maybe stay in Columbus for 2 days.
Good night, catching up calls and a dance in town. So love that we're rebels and we still believe we're the kind of crazy people wish that they could be.
Now the 50-50 drawing coming up. $2,475 to the winner. Olivia Tordoff, Ohio Youth President and American Quarter Horse Association Youth President, will be involved in the draw. So Olivia, congratulations on all your achievements. We're glad you're here. Caleb Sturgeon, Ohio Director and AQHA Youth Executive Member, also involved in the drawing. So, who is ready to win $2,475? Here we go. 6940276. 6940276. That money is all yours, at least for a moment. 6940276.
Somebody's gonna hurt someone before the night is through. somebody's gonna come undone. There's nothing we can do. Everybody wants to touch somebody. If it takes all night, everybody wants to take a little chance. Make it come out right. There's gonna be a heartache tonight. A heartache tonight, I know. There's gonna be a heartache tonight. A heartache tonight, I know. Yeah, I know.
Last call on 694-0276.
Some folks can't hold out that long. Nobody wants to go.
Yay.
What's going on? This night is gonna last forever. Last all summer long.
I'll get you here in a few minutes.
Sometime before the sun comes up, the radio is gonna play that song. There's gonna be a heartache tonight.
The winner, congratulations, Julie Dunks from Union City, Michigan. $2,475, and just because you're from Michigan, that's okay. Congratulations. How about that, ladies and gentlemen? And it's straight. They could be in a carpet rolling contest.
Break my heart.
The All-American Quarter Horse Congress is pleased to present the crowning of the 2018 Congress Queen. Throughout her reign, the Congress Queen serves as an ambassador for the Congress and the Ohio Quarter Horse Association. She is selected based on poise, industry knowledge, and equestrian skill assessed through a professional interview, a written exam, and a horsemanship class. With us tonight presenting the candidates are five of the Congress finest, Kerry Cooper, Clint Irwin, RJ Jacobs, Dakota Yoder, and Corbin Troyer. First, let's welcome from the Arkansas Quarter Horse Association, Ashton Williams. Coming in next, Annalise Ritzy from Buckeye Southern Quarter Horse. From Eastern Ohio Quarter Horse, Stacy Henry. Taylor Foster, Indiana Quarter Horse Association Queen. From Michigan Quarter Horse, Lauren Barnes. From the New York State Quarter Horse Association, Claire Flynn. Representing Northern Ohio Quarter Horse, Alexis Taylor. From Northern West Virginia Quarter Horse, Sydney Ibera. Representing Ohio, Michigan, Indiana Quarter Horse, Fallon Harkin. From the Ohio Quarter Horse Racing Association, Alexis Seamack. From Ontario Quarter Horse, Tiana Dominguez. From South Carolina Quarter Horse, Allison Henson. From Southern Ohio Quarter Horse, Bailey Haas. Representing the Tri-State Quarter Horse Association, Mariah Scherer. From Virginia Quarter Horse, Carly Massey. From West Virginia Quarter Horse, Carly Todd. And let's welcome Wisconsin Quarter Horse Association Queen, Shelby Petler. Ladies and gentlemen, the Wells Fargo Stagecoach. For people in the 1800s, the arrival of the stagecoach with the latest mail and treasure box was a part of their daily lives. Wells Fargo is proud to present the stagecoach as an authentic part of the company's past and a living part of American history. Cars and planes may be the quickest way to travel today, but in the 1800s, the stagecoach was the fastest option. They used a relay system and replaced tired horses with fresh ones every 10 to 20 miles to keep traveling day and night. A journey by a single person could take weeks. Traveling alone by horse, but the stagecoach could arrive in days. In the 1800s, stagecoaches were more than just a way to travel. They helped people stay connected. They carried mail, news, even money. Business owners used to send instructions and payments to towns across America, as the arrival of the stagecoach was such a big part of each day. Escorting our current Congress Queen is Columbus City Council President Shannon Harden. Council President Harden has been a member of City Council in Columbus since 2014 and was named Council President in January. Born and raised here in Columbus, he grew up around horses and regularly attended the Congress. He's been a longtime advocate and voice for the American Quarter Horse Congress. He and his city council colleagues share in support and appreciate the impact of the Congress on the city. Thank you, Council President Harden. Now, ladies and gentlemen, in her last official duty as 2017 Congress Queen, we present Sarah Loughlin.
My entire childhood, I looked forward to the magic of the All-American Quarter Horse Congress. As I practiced, I would dream of the sweet victory I would feel with a Schneider's Trophy coat around my shoulders. This industry continuously empowers me to pursue my ambitions, no matter how large. Last year, I graciously accepted my first Don's Bell Bronze Trophy upon being crowned the 2017 All-American Quarter Horse Congress Queen. It is humbling and a great honor to win a title based on the character and integrity I developed through my involvement with the American Quarter Horse. In the past 365 days, I have traveled to six different states, advocated to several Ohio state representatives, spoken to various 4-H clubs and agricultural groups, judged a high school rodeo contest, and learned how to make a custom show saddle from start to finish. I have few words to describe what it feels like to pass out awards alongside a family in honor of their child, or to hear someone say they worked their whole life just to become a finalist at a championship show. Aside from sheer inspiration, learning about each and every one of your passions has put my own values into perspective and has reminded me how every opportunity we have is a gift. I want to say thank you to Chris Cecil Darnell, Dr. Scott Myers, the entire Ohio Quarter Horse Association, my awards family, and the Congress Queen team for not only putting on a contest that honors the purest qualities of our industry's women, but for allowing me to represent the largest single-breed horse show in the world. Diligence, perseverance, resilience, and leadership are just four of the traits you've continuously instilled in me through my involvement with your group. My sincerest thanks to the amazing sponsors who ensured I looked and felt my best each and every day. It was an honor to represent your business. I want to give thanks to Eastern Ohio for believing in my abilities to become Congress Queen. You all truly have the biggest hearts. Thank you to my parents and family for the countless sacrifices you have made and the support you have given to see my dreams come to fruition. And of course, thank you to my friends, followers, and the entire community for being such a special part of my story. Finally, I wish the best of luck to all of the ladies standing in the arena tonight. You have embarked on the experience of a lifetime, and you deserve to enjoy every moment. I hope that as Congress Queen, I prove to you that you do not need to have won a championship to make a difference. There are so many other ways to realize your potential, and it is important to be curious, be kind to one another, and to never give up on what may seem like an impossible dream. I hope I was able to show you that we are all authentic and beautiful in our own way, and we do not need a crown to lead one another. I stand before you tonight for the very last time to show you what you can become through the influence of the American Quarter Horse. For this opportunity, I am forever grateful. I am Sarah Elizabeth Laughlin, and it has been one of my life's greatest pleasures to represent all of you as the 2017 All-American Quarter Horse Congresswoman.
Thank you, Sarah Laughlin. Congratulations. What a wonderful ambassador, and I might add, now a development officer for Nationwide Children's Hospital. We welcome you and we thank you. And now the moment this group has been waiting for through much hard work, interview, test, horsemanship, and many, many hours of preparation. Results of the interview in 10th place. We congratulate Alexa C. Mack, Ohio Quarter Horse Racing Association. In 9th, Carly Massey, Virginia Quarter Horse. In 8th, Bailey Haas, Southern Ohio Quarter Horse. Placing 7th, Mariah Shearer, Tri-State Quarter Horse. In 6th place, Tiana Dominguez, Ontario Quarter Horse. Fifth place goes to Claire Flynn, New York State Quarter Horse Association. In fourth place, Alexis Taylor, Northern Ohio. Third place overall for the interview, Allison Henson, South Carolina Quarter Horse. Your reserve winner in the interview, we congratulate Taylor Foster, Indiana Quarter Horse. And now the winner of the interview competition. We congratulate Ashton Williams, Arkansas Quarter Horse. Congratulations. Now on the written exam. One of the very, very equally difficult parts of the competition. In 10th place, congratulations, Carly Massey, Virginia Quarter Horse. In 9th place, Shelby Petler, Wisconsin Quarter Horse. In eighth place, Allison Henson, South Carolina. Seventh place, congratulations, Tiana Dominguez, Ontario Quarter Horse. Sixth place, congratulations, Alexis Taylor, Northern Ohio Quarter Horse. In fifth place, Alexis C. Mack, Ohio Quarter Horse Racing. Fourth place, Claire Flynn, New York State Quarter Horse. In third place, Ashton Williams, Arkansas Quarter Horse. Second place, Mariah Scherer, Tri-State Quarter Horse. And the winner of the written exam, Taylor Foster, Indiana Quarter Horse. In the horsemanship, 10th place, Lauren Barnes, Michigan Quarter Horse. 9th place, Fallon Harkin, Ohio, Michigan, Indiana. 8th place, Sydney Ibera, Northern West Virginia. Seventh place is Tiana Dominguez, Ontario Quarter Horse. Sixth place, Carly Massey, Virginia Quarter Horse. Fifth place, congratulations, Alexis Taylor, Northern Ohio. Fourth place, Mariah Scherer, Tri-State Quarter Horse. In third place, Ashton Williams, Arkansas. Your reserve in horsemanship, congratulations, Annalise Ritzy, Buckeye Southern. And now the winner of the horsemanship. Congratulations, Taylor Foster, Indiana Quarter Horse. Now a very special award, Miss Congeniality. And we congratulate Alexis C. Mack, Ohio Quarter Horse Racing. Presenting the second runner-up, Congratulations, Mariah Shearer, Tri-State Quarter Horse. The first runner-up, All-American Quarter Horse Congress Queen, Ashton Williams, Arkansas. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's put your hands together as we welcome our 2018 All-American Quarter Horse Congress Queen from Indiana, Taylor Foster. Congratulations. Taylor is the daughter of Greg and Nancy Foster. By the way, Nancy was the 1978 Indiana Quarter Horse Queen. Taylor is employed full-time by the Dermatology Center of Indianapolis as a patient service rep focused on customer service. She's nearly complete with her associate's degree and will transfer to a Bachelor of Business Admin. Taylor has said that giving back to the breed has given her such a privilege. Congratulations. All-American Quarter Horse Congress Queen, Taylor Foster. Thank you. And thanks again to Wells Fargo as Taylor Foster gets ready to head on out. Thank you, the Wells Fargo Stagecoach. And in the ring now, the sponsor of this fine event, DAC Vitamins and Minerals. From Somerton, South Carolina, show your support for DAC Power Trainers Jay and Christy Starnes and their son Logan. From Argyle, Texas, let's hear it for Robin Pritt, and from Pavo, Georgia, Cody Parrish. Also on board are DAC Territory Managers, Katie Elizabeth and Everett Troyer. Once again, DAC Vitamins and Minerals, owner and retired Halter Horse Trainer, Randy Jacobs and his wife, Holly, get on your feet and show your support. Make sure you hang on to your freestyle ticket. You'll find it a coupon for $5 off your purchase at the DAC booth. Well, we're just about ready to resume here in the Coliseum. Be ready to go in just a moment. And we're ready to resume now with draw number 11, number 3289. Gabriel Cumbo with Doolin Pepe Nick from Carlton, Michigan. Melinda Adams is on deck, Keith Cedia in the hole. This is draw number 11, Gabriel Cumbo. Gabriel Cumbo, ladies and gentlemen, and now it's score time. Thank you. On that ride, there will be a score of zero because not all the required maneuvers were performed. Score is zero, Gabrielle Kembo. Coming in next, draw number 12, number 6076, Melinda Adams with Bella Beretta from Windham, Ohio. Here's to all the scrappy mares like Retta. She's come back from being abused and keeps fighting. But she says, if I ride any other horse, it's on. Melinda Adams, ladies and gentlemen, and now it's score time. Score 190 on that ride, 190 for Melinda Adams. Next up, draw number 13, number 8203. Red Gun 2, written by Keith Cedia, known by Karen Shedlauskas, Austintown, Ohio. Gabriella Cowan will be on deck, John Hunter in the hole. This is draw number 13, Keith Cediap. Now it's score time. Score of 226 on that drive. 226. 226 for Keith Cedillo on Red Gun 2, owned by Karen Shedlaskas. Next to work will be draw number 14, number 9204. ATI Gold Cadillac, written and owned by Gabriella Cowan, Southgate, Michigan. John Hunter's on deck. Kendall Lewis in the hole. This is draw number 14, Gabriella Cowan. This one is for you, Evelyn.
Your husband, he is a few things you need to know it. You wanna be my one and only all my life.
Take me on a day, I deserve a break. And don't forget the flowers that bring universal.
Gabriella, how about it? Score 208 on that drive, 208 for Gabriella Cowan. We're up to draw number 15 now. This is number 4123. John wanted us to share that since his horse, Wayward CJ, turned 19 this year, and John is 69, They put their heads together and came up with the idea to do this run as 1969. Although this is John's first AQHA-NRHA event in 50 years, since that time, careers and life somehow got in the way. But he wants you all to know it's really good to be back. John would like to dedicate this performance to CJ, a great little horse who always does his best to be the little engine that could. John Hunter, ladies and gentlemen, and now it's score time. John Hunter from Chicago, Illinois on Wayward CJ.
Oh,
Score 201 for John Hunter. 201. Next to work is draw number 16, number 8479. Kendall Lewis with Debbie's Little Trip from Dallas, Pennsylvania. Angie Reichert's on deck. Drake Johnson in the hole. Kendall would like to dedicate this ride to her friend Carolyn, who has been fighting cancer for many years. Thank you for inspiring her to never give up on her dreams. Ladies and gentlemen, Kendall Lewis. Kendall Lewis, ladies and gentlemen, and now it's score time. Score 203 on the last drive. 203. Yes, the boo-o-meter is on. And that was one of the good high scores on the boo-o-meter. Coming in next, draw number 17, number 3833, Angie Reichert with Shirley Cash and Checks, owned by Linda Williams for Walton Beach, Florida. Reichert, ladies and gentlemen, and now it's score time.
Thank you.
score 217 on the last drive. 217 for Angie Reichert. Next up, draw number 18, number 6448, Drake Johnson with Hollywood Rowdy, owned by Austin Gamer of Sutton, Nebraska. Drake Johnson will be riding Hollywood Rowdy. Coming in, his tribute to Old Blue Eyes. Johnson, ladies and gentlemen, and now it's score time. Better not leave that martini glass too close to the judge. I bet it's empty now.
Well, I feel that I'm out.
Score of 219 and one half, 219 and a half. Coming in next, draw number 19, number 2077, Lisa Gern with West Coast Vaquero from Bailey, Michigan. Luke Gingrich is on deck. No one ever made a difference by being like anyone else. P.T. Barnum, the greatest showman. Lisa Gern, ladies and gentlemen, and now it's score time. Score 204 and one half on that drive. 204 and a half. Next up, our final entry, draw number 20, number 3311, Luke Gingrich with C.J. Rios and Bargan, Plain City, Ohio.
Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Luke Gingrich, ladies and gentlemen, and now it's score time. Score of 224 and one half on that ride. 224 and a half. Attention all freestylers, we're going to invite you all back into the ring now for the results. Once again, all freestylers, come on back in.
Thank you.
Did you all know that our sponsor, DAC Vitamins and Minerals, has more than 40 proven equine supplements? In addition, they carry the show contender line for show pig, steer, goat, and sheep. You can feed DAC Vitamins and Minerals to get the competitive edge in the show pen. And once again, many thanks to our event sponsor, DAC. The winner of Open Freestyle winner reigning, in addition to the $7,000 to first place, receives the winner's jacket from Snyder's, the trophy from Ohio Quarter Horse, the hay bag from Tribute, and a blue ribbon saddle courtesy of Ohio Quarter Horse. Second place receives a certificate for a pair of bent rail boots from Justin, the trophy spurs from Rods. Third receives a gift certificate from Good Ride, and fourth the head stall from J.R. Winger. Non-pro freestyle reigning, also sponsored by DAC. The winner to receive a trophy belt buckle from Montana Silversmiths, courtesy of Ohio Quarter Horse. The winner's jacket from Snyder's. The trophy from Ohio Quarter Horse. The hay bag from Tribute Equine. Second place, the trophy spurs from Rods. The certificate for the bent rail boots. Third place, the certificate from Good Ride. Fourth, the certificate from Chicks. Fourth, the head stall from J.R. Winger. And fifth, the gift certificate from Good Ride. Final results, NRHA Open Freestyle Reigning. The first duty for Congress Queen Tiffany Foster. Once again, congratulations. Tenth place, Open Freestyle Reigning. Congratulations to Kendall Lewis with Debbie's Little Trip from Dallas, Pennsylvania. Ninth place, congratulations, Lindsay Hendren with Roxy's Custom Crone, Ferndale, Michigan. Place, congratulations, Martin Schwartz with Show Me Sterling, owned by Guy Cutshaw, Milton, Kentucky. Taylor Foster making the awards presentation. In seventh place, congratulations, Jacob Cam with Okie's Poco Chloe on the Whitney Lock, Lima, Ohio. Sixth place, congratulations, Angie Reichert with Shirley Cash and Checks on the Linda Williams for Walton Beach, Florida. Fifth place, congratulations to Drake Johnson with Hollywood Rowdy owned by Austin Gamer, Sutton, Nebraska. Fourth place, along with $1,753, Carla Ribordi with A Spark of Sunshine, owned by Petra Pearson, Cox Creek, Kentucky. And we're happy to have Mr. R.J. Jacobs of the DAC Company assisting in the awards presentation. Third place, along with $3,506, Luke Gingrich with CJ Rio Zambargan, Plain City, Ohio. Now presenting the reserve champion of NRHA Open Freestyle reigning and a paycheck of $5,259. Congratulations, Keith Cedia with Red Gun 2, owned by Karen Shedlaskis, Austintown, Ohio. Congratulations, Keith Cedia, reserve champion. And now, presenting the winner and a paycheck of $7,000, Dan James with Don Magnum, Midway, Kentucky. Congratulations, Congress Open Freestyle Champion. Receiving the winner's jacket from Snyder's, the trophy from OQHA, the hay bag from Tribute, the blue ribbon trophy saddle being presented by Congress Queen Taylor Foster and sponsor R.J. Jacobs of the DAC Company. Once again, our champion, Dan James on Don Magnum. Congratulations. Now the results of non-pro freestyle reigning. In 10th place, we congratulate Gabrielle Cumbo with Duel and Peppy Nick, owned by Nicole Cumbo of Carlton, Michigan. Ninth place, congratulations, Melinda Adams with Bella Beretta from Windham, Ohio. In eighth place, congratulations, John Hunter with Wayward CJ, Chicago, Illinois. seventh place. Congratulations, Lindsay Hendren with Roxy's Custom Chrome, Ferndale, Michigan. Seventh place. In sixth place, congratulations, Lisa Gern with West Coast Vaquero, Bailey, Michigan. In fifth place, congratulations, Gabriella Cowan with ATI Gold Cadillac from Southgate, Michigan. Fourth place in a paycheck for $338. Congratulations, Kayla Shelnut with Tag This, Loganville, Georgia. In third place, and a paycheck of $676, Leah Michelle Moore with Spooked by Starlight, Farmersville, Ohio. Second place and reserve champion, a paycheck of $1,000. Congratulations, reserve non-pro freestyle reigning champion, BB Shortle, Baird, Nebraska. Congratulations, reserve champion non-pro freestyle. Now presenting our champion, NRHA non-pro freestyle reigner, all the way from Bishop, California, a paycheck of $1,300. Congratulations, Rob Pierce, RCY King Silver. Congratulations, non-pro freestyle reigning champion, Rob Pierce, Bishop, California. Congratulations. Once again, thanks to everyone who came and enjoyed. We really appreciate your being here. And thanks again to the DAC Company for sponsoring this major event at the All-American Quarter Horse Congress. Thank you all. Have a good evening here in Columbus.